Hey everybody, welcome to another episode of Live Sound for Acoustic Guitar. And in today's episode, I'm going to be talking about pickups and just explaining how I've gone about deciding what pickups to include in my guitars. And I'll mainly be focusing on, I've got two groupings or two categories of pickups to look for. And usually you see people grouping pickups based on how they're installed or the way the electronics work. And that really is irrelevant when you're trying to decide on what's going to make your guitar sound the best. And so that's what we're going to look at today. I wanted to explain a little bit more on my approach and kind of the purpose of these videos and what I think a good sound is, what the goal is. So these videos are for a good sound for a solo guitarist. And I'm doing these videos and I'm taking this approach because I don't find hardly any information out there, and a lot of people are getting misled. I've been misled over and over because you look up information on pickups for acoustic guitar and you look up what gear to get, and almost all of it is geared towards a guitarist that's going to be playing in a band. And if you follow that advice as a solo guitarist, your sound's going to be kind of thin, kind of mid-range sounding, and your audience won't enjoy it as much, and it's not nearly as enjoyable to perform with that kind of sound. So as a solo guitarist, we want a big, full sound. Your guitar is the band, and so it needs to cover it all. And I've even found with acoustic amplifiers designed for acoustic guitars, they seem to actually be tuned kind of in the way you would want a guitar for a band. They're more mid-range sounding, and they don't tend to cover that full spectrum. I've tried some really top-notch ones too, and they just, at least for me, they don't do it. And so that's why I'm doing these videos, trying to give you my perspective on what a solo guitarist needs to get a great sound. So I like to group pickups into two categories based on sound. And so the two categories that I have are air or resonance, pickups that are going to grab kind of that body sound of the guitar. They might pick up drumming on the guitar, and just those things that make it sound more like a natural acoustic guitar. And we're going to go over what types of pickups fall in that category. And then the other category is the direct signal, pickups that are going to grab more of the string sound. They might sound a little more electronic, but they're really getting kind of a meaty sound and a clear sound. And it's really hard for a pickup in this category to have characteristics of that direct signal, and it's hard for ones in this category getting that real clear sound to also grab resonance from the guitar. And some pickups actually try to bridge this gap, and I don't know if anybody's ever, like, if they group them this way. I've never seen anyone group them this way, but you know, there are pickups in this air and resonance category that they try to do things to get a little more clarity into the sound, but they really can't do it nearly as well as a pickup in this category could. And same thing for pickups in that direct signal category. They try to get that resonance sound into the pickup and they just can't do it. They usually do it with some kind of processing. So it's not actually grabbing the resonance and air from your guitar. It's just taking some digital form of resonance and applying it to the signal. So, all right, so I want to go over the types of pickups that fall into each category. So our first, so we're going to start with looking at the air category. And the first type of pickup is a soundboard transducer. So this is a pickup that attaches somewhere onto the top of the guitar. Well, it'd be on the inside of the guitar usually. So like a K&K pickup, which are very popular. Those stick onto the bridge plate inside the guitar, kind of under the bridge here. And so that's grabbing that vibration from the top of the guitar, and people like them because it has a nice airy sound as more of a natural sound. And then your other ones. These are both kind of similar. Are your internal and your external microphones. And obviously those are going to grab that air and resonance. So an internal mic a lot of times is placed right in the sound hole. So K&K, they've got a microphone like that. Some people, as far as real high quality ones, like to get the DPA 4061, which is what I use in all of my guitars. And they mount them inside the guitar. And then, of course, an external mic would just be a microphone on a stand out in front of the guitar. For our direct signal pickups, those are going to be UST, stands for under saddle transducer. And what that looks like is it actually goes right under the white piece, the saddle of the guitar. There's going to be a little coax type cable or a little strip of metal. So it's a pickup right under that. And that gets a very direct sound. And then our final type is the magnetic sound hole pickup, which is a pickup that goes right in the sound hole here. And it acts just like a pickup on an electric guitar. And it's grabbing the sound of the strings quite directly. So if you've looked at pickups and pickup comparisons and what people say to get, you've probably heard some of this stuff. I'm just going to explain some of my recommendations and things that a lot of people don't think about, and what most pickup companies don't think about, and what most guitar builders don't think about when trying to take a nice guitar and put pickups in it. So one of the things that happens on a guitar, so a builder makes a nice instrument, they tune the top to have this specific resonant frequency, so it rings at a certain tone. And if you change the weight on the top of that guitar, you change that resonant tone, and it needs to be very specific. A very detailed luthier is going to want it to be at a specific frequency. And that kind of has to do with their preferences and also the style of music you play. And I'm sure there's other variables. I'm not a guitar builder, but I work with different guitar builders and have learned a lot about this over the years. So with that in mind, if you change the weight to the top of the guitar, you're changing that resonant frequency, which may cause some clashing. If you play a certain note, it may kind of start to sound like something's out of tune almost on the guitar. So if we take a soundboard transducer, something that's kind of heavy. I know like the I-beam pickup is pretty heavy. You put that on the guitar and you're adding weight. So you're actually lowering the frequency. And one luthier told me that basically for every gram that you add of weight to the top, you actually lower it 1 hertz. And I did a testing on this, and maybe in another video I'll show my testing results, where I did some tone tapping. You're basically taking the guitar, you're tapping the top, through a microphone and some software it can show what frequency, where the resonant frequency is, and just what's going on tonally. So I did a testing. I took a pickup that was 8 grams and had it on there, and it was a very high quality pickup, and it lowered it 8 hertz. And that's not desirable. It was a really nice guitar. It was made by Jim Triggs, and And I didn't want that. So when you're looking in this category, you want to be careful. To me, a soundboard transducer is a great pickup for getting resonance without having the problems of too much feedback. And to me, the K&K pickup is very lightweight. I forget how much it weighs, but it's kind of the lightest soundboard transducer, so it's going to have the least amount of effect on that resonant frequency. And I actually had one of my guitar made by Brian Gallup. I took that back to him and had him revoice it after I installed my pickups so that it sat right where it needed to be. So that's just something to really keep in mind when you're choosing pickups. If you've got a guitar that the tone is very specific. Now, of course, your problems with microphones are feedback, and they also do not get the low end very well. An external mic probably can, but the internal mics, you pretty much, when I've had them, I pretty much cut off all the lows and just get the mid to upper range. So to me, for that air, you really have to have a soundboard transducer that's going to get that a pretty full range of sound. I add in the internal mic to get more of the body drumming and percussion, and it also adds just a little more detailed clarity in the sound. So moving on to the direct type pickups, there's a problem with the undersaddle transducers, and these are probably, it seems like any guitar that comes with a pickup in it pretty much always has an undersaddle pickup. And the problem is, the way the guitar works, the string vibrates, comes down to the bridge, and you want that bridge to be vibrating. And if you've got a pickup right under that saddle, especially if it's they're kind of like tubular coax type ones, and they're kind of spongy almost. What happens is it hits the saddle, vibrates down, and then it hits that pickup, and that pickup absorbs a lot of the vibrations. And so those vibrations don't transfer to the top of the guitar, and you lose resonance. Your guitar, you'll lose kind of the sustain quality, a bit of sustain quality, or you'll have a bit of muting. And it might be subtle, but I've tried it back and forth and found that it's noticeable, and it causes me to lose that kind of inspiration in the music. So for me, an undersaddle pickup is kind of a no-no. If you get the flat type, I think that works better. But they don't sound as good as the coax type, actually. And so the reason I know they put them in all those guitars is that the coax type, they sound good. You can get a good sound coming out of a sound system. You don't have feedback issues nearly as much as any of these types of pickups. And so it's reliable and it sounds good, but it doesn't sound like your guitar. And if you've got a really nice instrument, a custom instrument, some vintage Martin or something like that, you want it to sound like that guitar. So I skip over this one and I go to the magnetic pickup, which has the problem, just like the undersaddle or the soundboard transducers, that you're adding weight to the top of the guitar. Now I did some testing, and I found that putting it right here by the tongue here, it doesn't seem to affect things too as much as if you put that weight right over here by the bridge. But if you have a really heavy magnetic pickup, it does suck a lot of life out of the guitar. And I've seen people take really nice instruments and they throw that sunrise pickup on there, or these big heavy magnetic pickups, and they might have batteries in them, and it can add a lot of weight and suck a lot of tone out. So to me, a very lightweight magnetic pickup is the way to go. I've been using the MySai pickups because they're really lightweight. And I know Fishman has maybe a couple that are really lightweight. I think that's maybe all I've seen that would be lightweight. I'm kind of curious about the Fishman's, but so for me, I'll just put a little star by the ones. That's kind of where I like to sit on these types of pickups. And again, staying lightweight. And there's always a way to wire things up. Here's a few things just to sum up. So I've starred my choices for types of pickups to combine. A soundboard transducer, if I'm just using one pickup, using my K&K pickup is what I'll use. It gets a natural sound and has a pretty full range sound. Adding in the magnetic pickup is really helpful in getting a fuller bass. It helps more with clarity and bringing out harmonics and tapping. So if I can, I try to add that in too. And then the internal mic, I actually haven't been using that as much just to avoid feedback issues. You know, every venue is different, and if I've got another, you know, someone running sound from the venue, that I'm just, you know, they're not used to having a guitar with an internal mic. So sometimes I just got to where I wasn't using that as much. But I'm kind of wanting to put it back in just to pick up more body percussion stuff because it's kind of lacking. And then I just wrote down here kind of the main reminders for each one. So if you're using a soundboard transducer or anything you're adding, especially to the top of the guitar, keep it really lightweight, as light as you can, so you're not changing that resonant frequency. And then for the direct ones, nothing under the saddle. You just lose a lot from that. And then again, keep it lightweight. Keep things light on the top. So hopefully that helps you to better piece together getting a really natural, full sound. Because remember, the goal of these videos for me is to share what's going to give you the best sound as a solo guitarist. Thanks again for watching. Please leave your comments, questions, your challenges, things that maybe you'd like me to dive in a little more in future videos, or you know, just let me know what you think. And if you like these videos, please subscribe and follow along. Planning on doing these for a while. I'm trying to be regular with them, but managing my studio is pretty busy. But this is something I've been wanting to do for a long time, and so I'm just had to make the decision to dive in and do it. So thanks again. We'll see you soon.